And now, one of the segments of our new impressions of the Far East suite. The scene is Isfahan, the solo by Johnny Hodges.
With one of the most recognizable tones in jazz, Duke Ellington said this of the great alto saxophonist Johnny Hodges. He had a tone so beautiful it sometimes brought tears to the eyes. Jazz writer Scott Janow said that Hodges possessed, quote, the most beautiful tone ever heard in jazz. John Cornelius Hodges was born in 1907 in Cambridge, Massachusetts, but grew up across the river in Boston. Among his childhood friends was baritone saxophonist Harry Carney. They would later play together in one of the world's greatest jazz bands. Johnny grew up playing piano and drums, but switched to soprano saxophone after seeing the great Sidney Bechet play in a Boston burlesque theater. In fact, Hodges' sister introduced Johnny to Bechet, who was impressed enough with the young man to mentor him. Hodges had multiple nicknames in his life, including Jeep, but Rabbit stuck the longest. According to tenor player Johnny Griffin, Rabbit stuck because he looked like a rabbit, no expression on his face while he's playing all this beautiful music. After making a name for himself in Boston, Hodges left for New York in 1924, playing with Bechet, Chick Webb, Willie the Lion Smith, and many others. He joined Duke Ellington's orchestra in 1928, and he never looked back. As a featured soloist in Ellington's band, many songs were written with his horn playing in mind. Standards like Passion Flower, Come Sunday, and Prelude to a Kiss. He was one of the prominent Ellington Band members who was featured in Benny Goodman's 1938 Carnegie Hall concert. Goodman described Hodges as, quote, by far the greatest man on alto sax that I have ever heard. Many musicians from different eras shared Goodman's sentiments. Hodges was known for his intense blues and luscious ballads. His haunting tone was one of incredible beauty and creativity. His strongly identifiable sound made him one of the best ever. Hodges, both as a member of Ellington's band and on his own, reaped many awards, voted 10 times Best Alto Sax Player by Down Beat magazine and twice by Metronome. While he was always associated with the Ellington Orchestra, Hodges made a name for himself with his many solo albums, collaborating often with members of Ellington's band and with the Duke himself.
The Voice of America presents Jazz Club USA.
Johnny Hodges is one of the great veterans of jazz, and incidentally one of the few New Englanders to make a name in the jazz world.
He played with and recorded with legends such as Charlie Parker, Jerry Mulligan, Wild Bill Davis, and even Lawrence Welk. When he died of a massive heart attack in 1962, Duke Ellington said, "Our band will never sound the same."